we'll be starting with the next 25 questions for the IAS 2018 GS paper 1. Now in this section, most of the questions were coming from were from the sections of economics. Most of them were direct questions from NCERT. Again, there were questions from NCERT directly in the sections on history. So let's look on to the questions one by one. The first question talks about the biographies of Mazzini, Garibaldi, Shivaji and Shri Krishna. These have been written by Lala Lajpat Rai. He was also elected to Central Assembly and stayed in America for some time. So Lala Lajpat Rai is the correct answer for this question. The next is, which of the following statements is correct? Now here, Aadhaar card can be used only as a proof of identity, not as a proof of citizenship. So first is incorrect. Again, once issued, it can be deactivated or omitted under certain conditions. So 2 is also incorrect. If it could be deactivated if the age group changes from 15 years. Again, if the details are incorrect, so there could be many reasons for duplication and incorrect information. These have been the common reasons for deactivation. So both the statements are incorrect there. The next question is, which of the following areas have shrunk in the recent past due to illegal human activity? The correct answer is the region close to the Aral Sea, and that is due to a lot of irrigation activities that has been seen in that area. The next question talks about the rule of law index. Now this is by the World Justice Project. Now as we know, there are every time there are questions on which of the indexes are from which body or which organization. So here it was again one question, and one question again as we would see on the Kaushal Yojana by which ministry. So those are something you should be very, very clear about for your prelims examination. So here you have the correct answer as World Justice Project. Now this is an American organization talking about the rule of law. The next question here talks about which of the following links all ATMs in India. So you have the National Finance Switch that is being linked by the National Payment Corporation of India, known as NPCI. So NPCI comes to be the correct answer here. The next is, what is legal tender money? So legal tender money is basically the bank money which is which a creditor is under the compulsion to basically accept in the settlement of his claim. So basically, if it's trying to extinguish any type of public or private debt and mete out any kind of financial obligation that could be seen here. Now, if a commodity is provided free to the public by the government, then the opportunity cost would be transferred to the consumer of the product to the government. The reason being, if the government is putting in money for, let's say, ration, the government is not able to put in money for other causes. So that's how it runs. So D becomes the correct answer. The next is, increase in the absolute and the per capita real GNP does not connote a higher level of economic development if the poverty and the unemployment rate increases. So C becomes the correct answer here. The next question talks about human capital formation. Now, human capital formation talks about increasing the knowledge, increasing the capital, the skill levels, and the capability of the people. So it basically focuses on accumulating intangible wealth, not a tangible wealth. Intangible wealth basically means which cannot be measured. And this is something, a direct question from your NCERT 11th Economics, Chapter 5. So you have a kind of direct flow from there. The next is, despite being a high saving economy, capital formation may not result in significant increased output due to high capital output ratio. So capital output ratio basically talks about the marginal amount of capital which is required for any entity to generate the next level of production. So here you have D as the correct answer. The next question talks about Santhal uprising. Now this has been covered again in NCERT class 9th, chapter 4th history. So we have talked about Birsa Munda and Santhal uprising. So Santhal uprising, once it subsided, it led to the evolution or the formation of Santhal Parganas. Again, under Santhal Parganas, it became illegal for the Santhals to transfer the land to any non-Santhal. So both the statements here are correct. The next question talks about economically, one of the results of British rule of India in the 19th century was. So the correct answer here is commercialization of Indian agriculture. This is again directly from the chapter of economic impacts of British rule from NIOS. So again, it's important. The next question The next question here talks about the president rule of India exercise. If the president of India exercises his power as provided under Article 365 of the Constitution in respect to a particular state, then the powers of the legislature shall be exercisable by the authority of the parliament. So B becomes the correct answer here. Now you have to match the craft with the heritage. So Puthukali shawls made by Toda tribes in Western Ghats. So Toda tribes live in Nilgiris in Western Ghats in Tamil Nadu. So that's the correct match. Sujani embroidery is from Bihar, and Upada Jamdani sarees are from Godavari areas. So 2 and 3 are the incorrect options. 1 is the correct match. So 1 only would be the correct answer here. Now next is, which of the following areas GPS can be used? So GPS basically is a global positioning system where we use triangulation technique. So it can be used in mobile operations, banking. It can be used for controlling the power grid. So all of these are correct answers. So GPS has its applications in numerous fields. Let's say if you want to locate a bank branch, you can do that by use of GPS. Mobile phone operations and power grids are obviously the correct answers here. The next is, which of the following statements are correct? Now here we are talking about the treasury bill. So treasury bills are issued only by the government of India, not by the state governments. That's correct. And treasury bill offers a discount at the par value or the face value. So both 2 and 3 are correct. However, Reserve Bank manages securities of Government of India as well as the state securities. So 1 is incorrect, 2 and 3 are the correct options here. The next is, we are talking about the Earth's magnetic field has reversed every few 100,000 years. That's correct. A direct question from Basics of Geography. So the concepts of geomagnetism, you can refer the class on geomagnetism for the same. So first is correct. However, when the Earth was created, there was no atmosphere. There was only carbon dioxide and little of water vapor that was seen because it was a kind of volcanic eruption, and later on the life came in. So 2 becomes incorrect. There was oxygen and no carbon dioxide is incorrect. And finally, when living organisms originated, they modified the early atmosphere of the Earth. So that's correct. So 1 and 3 are the correct options here. So C becomes the correct choice. The next question talks about the term WannaCry, Petty and Eternal Blue. Now, when we are talking about this, it's very important, just go back, check on the class on malwares that we have done. So WannaCry, Petty are basically ransomwares, and Eternal Blue is a part of NSA toolbox for hacking. So all of those relate to cyber attacks. So C becomes your correct answer. 2 questions from cyber attacks, as we discussed in the expected questions. The class on Bitcoin and malware was important. So here you have 2 questions directly from that section. The next is conservation agriculture. Conservation agriculture talks about 3 things: no tillage or minimum tillage. So 2 is the correct option. Then it talks about using crop residue to cover the soil surface and adopting a kind of crop rotation or crop sequencing. So 2, 4 and 5 are the correct statements here for conservation agriculture, which is a new form of farming, basically farming method, where we talk about these 3 principles as we discussed. 6 mass extinction, we have discussed it a lot of time. It was very, very important, and here you had the question. So you had the Wilkinson's report, that was part of it, the global the coral bleaching. And 6 mass extinction basically talks about human interference and how human overuse or over exploitation of the resources has led to loss of natural habitat, pollution and global climatic change. So D becomes the correct answer for your 6 mass extinction. Then you have English education in India. Now the introduction is attributed to all the 3 concepts, that Charter Act of 1813. Then you have the General Committee of Public Instruction that came up later in 1823, and in between the 2 you had the Orientalist and the Angelist controversy, where they said that modern Indian language should be promoted, the traditional Sanskrit language should be promoted versus the English language should be promoted. So these 3 were the language controversies under the Orientalist and the Angelist. So all 3 of these talk about English education system. So all 3 of these are the correct answers here. The next is, which of the following is an artificial lake? So Kolero, Nainital, Renuka are all natural lakes. Kodaikanal is an only artificial or man-made lake from among these. So that lies in Ooty. Now this has been covered in our Geography Through Maps, the basic books that we have covered. And as we have seen, there are 2 questions from basic geography so far. The next is the Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Yojana. As we said, this comes under Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So first itself becomes incorrect. You have 2 and 3, that's correct. It's basically aligned to the competencies of the NSQF, that's the National Skill Qualification Framework, and also imparting the training for soft skills and entrepreneurship. So 2 and 3 are the correct, but the ministry is incorrect. It's Ministry of Skill Development and Entrepreneurship. So 1 becomes the incorrect option here. The next is, which of the following changed its name to Swarajya Sabha? So All India Home Rule League changed its name to Swaraj Sabha in 1920 after Gandhiji had become the president of it later. The next is, which of the following event happened earliest? So Arya Samaj was established in 1875, Neel Darpan in 1858. Then you have Anand Math, that came as a novel by Bankim Chandra Chattopadhyay in 1882, and Satyendranath Tagore was appointed as a civil servant in 1863. So you have among these, the first one was Neel Darpan by Deenbandhu Mitra. Now even if you know the chronological order of which person came first, you can answer these kind of questions. So this was a kind of direct question from your history. Again, if you have been doing NCERTs thoroughly, these were some of the direct questions directly applicable from your NCERT. So with this, we covered the next set of 25 questions. We'll be coming up with the next 25 and the next 25 questions soon. Stay tuned, join us, do forward this. Have a great day.